We're in Luke chapter 12. In the meantime, when many thousands of the multitude were gathered together, so much so that they trod upon one another, he began to say unto his disciples, first of all, beware you of the leaven of the Pharisees. Their doctrine is that Christ was God. He says, Christ continues, which is hypocrisy. But there is nothing covered up that shall not be revealed and hid that shall not be known. Wherefore, whatever you have said in the darkness shall be heard in the light, and what you have spoken in the ear in the inner chamber shall be proclaimed upon the housetops. And I say unto you, my friends, be not afraid of them that kill the body, and after that have no more that they can do. But I warn you who you shall fear. Fear him who after he is killed has power to cast into hell. Yes, I say unto you, fear him. Are not five sparrows sold for 2 pence? And not one of them is forgotten in the sight of God. But the very hairs of your head are all numbered. Fear not. You are of more value than many sparrows. And I say unto you, everyone who shall confess me before men, him shall the Son of Man also confess before the messengers of God, that is the Father and the Holy Spirit. But he that denies me in the presence of men shall be denied in the presence of the messengers of God. Those who've refused to believe in the might and power and glory of Christ and that he will be sanctified and he will be glorified in the second age of the kingdom of heaven. And everyone who shall speak a word against the Son of Man, it shall be forgiven him. But unto him that blasphemes against the Holy Spirit, again, we got by with being denominationalists. We had no choice. But when you argue against objective truth from God, you can't be forgiven because you won't repent. Christ continues, it shall not be forgiven. And when they bring you before the synagogues and the rulers and authorities, be not anxious how or what you shall answer or what you shall say. For the Holy Spirit shall teach you in that very hour what you ought to say. And that's only for the apostles. We are going to have the rod of iron. We are going to learn how to allow Christ to be our preacher. And one out of the multitude said unto him, teacher, bid my brother divide the inheritance with me. But he said unto him, man, who made me a judge or a divider over you? And he said unto them, take heed and keep yourselves from all covetousness, for a man's life consists not in the abundance of the things which he possesses. Now, of course, under Gnosticism, things were different, but we are going to have to learn not to be concerned about our possessions. And he spoke a parable unto them, saying, the ground of a certain rich man brought forth plentifully. And he reasoned within himself, saying, what shall I do? Because I have not where to bestow my fruits. And he said, this will I do. I will pull down my barns and build greater, and there I will bestow all my grain and my goods. And I will say to my soul, soul, you have much good laid up for many years. Take your ease, eat, drink, and be merry. But God said unto him, you foolish one, this night is your soul required of you. And the things which you have prepared, whose shall they be? So is he that lays up treasure for himself and is not rich toward God. Don't consider the kingdom of heaven. And he, that is Jesus, said unto his disciples, therefore I say unto you, be not anxious for your life, what you shall eat, nor yet for your body, what you shall put on. For the life is more than the food, and the body than the raiment. So we've got to transform our minds, don't we? Consider the ravens, that they sow not, neither reap, which have no store chamber nor barn, and God feeds them. Of how much more value are you than the birds? And which of you, by being anxious, can add a cubit unto the measure of his life? If then you are not able to do even that which is least, why are you anxious concerning the rest? Consider the lilies, how they grow. They toil not, neither do they spin. Yet I say unto you, even Solomon in all his glory was not arrayed like one of these. But if God does so clothe the grass of the field, which today is and tomorrow is cast into the oven, how much more shall he clothe you, O you of little faith? You know, all the finest things in this life are going to be available for the meek that inherit the earth. And we're going to share these with each other. And so the Lord provides the very best for those in his own kingdom. And seek you not what you shall eat and what you shall drink, neither be you of double mind. For all these things do the nations of the world seek after. But your Father knows that you have need of these things. Yet seek you his kingdom, and all these things shall be added unto you." There's one thing to think about, is the kingdom of heaven. You know how The Matrix is a great movie because it shows us that there could be something greater in life. And that's what the kingdom is. We don't have to have dreams like The Matrix. We don't have to watch movies like that to have hope. If we think about the kingdom, it's going to be have a lot better ending than The Matrix had. Seek first the kingdom, and God's going to take care of all these other things if we will seek after the kingdom. Jesus continues, "Fear not, little flock, for it is your Father's good pleasure to give you the kingdom. Sell that which you have and give alms. Make for yourselves purses which wax not old, a treasure in the heaven that fail not, where no thief draws near, neither moth destroys. For where your treasure is, there will your heart be also. Let your loins be girded about, and your lamps burning, and be you yourselves likened to men looking for their Lord, when he shall return from the marriage feast, that when he comes and knocks, they may straightway open unto him." You see, the marriage feast is the kingdom of heaven, and we are like the five wise virgins, we hope. "Blessed are those servants who the Lord, when he comes, shall find watching. Verily I say unto you, that he shall gird himself and make them sit down to meat, and shall come and serve them. And if he shall come in the second watch, and if in the third, and find them so, blessed are those servants. But know this, that if the master of the house had known at what in what hour the thief was coming, he would have watched and not have left his house to be broken through. Be you also ready, for in an hour that you think not, the Son of Man comes." And Peter says, "Lord, speak you this parable unto us, or even unto all." And the Lord said, "Who then is the faithful and wise steward, whom his Lord shall set over his household to give them their portions of food in due season? Blessed is that servant whom his Lord, when he comes, shall find so doing. Of a truth, I say unto you, that he will set him over all that he has." You see, we are to be practicing for the kingdom of heaven, getting ready for the kingdom of heaven. Our Lord continues, "But if that servant shall say in his heart, my Lord delays his coming, and shall begin to beat the men servants and the maid servants, and to eat and drink and be drunken, the Lord of that servant shall come in a day when he is not expected, and in an hour when he knows not, and he shall cut him asunder and appoint his portion with the unfaithful. And that servant who knew his Lord's will and made not ready, nor did according to his will, shall be beaten with many stripes. But he that knew not and did things worthy of stripes shall be beaten with few stripes. And to whoever much is given, of him shall much be required." So Peter, was that talking to you? That's the point, isn't it? Yes, he was talking to them. And to those of us who are blessed to understand these matters, more is expected of us. "And to whom they commit much, of him will they ask the more. I came to cast fire upon the earth, and what do I desire if it is already kindled? But I have an immersion to be immersed with, and how am I straitened till it be accomplished? Do you think that I am come to give peace to the earth? I tell you no, but rather division. For there shall be from henceforth five in one house divided, three against two and two against three. They shall be divided, father against son and son against father, mother against daughter and daughter against her mother, mother-in-law against her daughter-in-law and daughter-in-law against her mother-in-law. From those who will confess Christ, those who will prepare for the kingdom of heaven and those who won't." Remember, Jerusalem was destroyed in 70 AD because people refused to give up their denominationalism. It was Gnostic Jerusalem that was destroyed then. "And he said to the multitudes also, when you see a cloud arising in the west, straightway you say, there comes a shower. And so it comes to pass. And when you see a south wind blowing, you say, there will be a scorching heat. And it comes to pass. You hypocrites, you know how to interpret the face of the earth and the heaven. But how is it that you know not how to interpret this time?" Many people in this world now recognize that the pendulum is swinging back the other way towards spiritual enlightenment. And these men just wanted things to continue as they were. They couldn't read the signs. And I think it's apparent to us all. Now the Lord has hid to us his wisdom about the kingdom of heaven, but now he's revealing it to us. And now our senses ought to be to where we recognize something big is about to happen. And why even of yourselves judge you not what is right? For as you're going with your adversary before the magistrate, on the way give diligence to be quiet of him, lest happily he drag you into the judge, and the judge shall deliver you to the officer, and the officer shall cast you into prison. I say unto you, you shall by no means come out thence till you have paid every last mite. You know, don't keep playing the games of modern politicians. Something big is about to happen. Second age of the kingdom of heaven is at hand in about 40 years. But as we noted in this context, not exactly 40. We're not going to know when the Lord's going to return for the second age of the kingdom of heaven. He wants us to get prepared and to be ready before he returns.